And when you finish, you should get something that looks similar to this. Hi, my name's Everett Minshall. I'm an aspiring machine learning engineer. And in today's video, I wanted to talk about what happens after you complete your degree at WGU. So this is the certificate you'll get. It'll look something like this. This is mine. It's a business administration and marketing at Governor's University in North Carolina. Took a lot of classes on marketing analytics. And yeah, that's what it looks like. In today's video, I wanted to talk a bit about what happens when you finish. So first, WGU, when you're pretty much close to being finished, you'll email your mentor and tell them you finished all of your courses and you've passed them all and you're ready to apply for your degree. Applying for a degree just means that you submit a form that says that everything's finished. The program administrators will go over all of the information that you've provided, and pretty soon after, they'll confirm that you are indeed finished and you're pretty much done. It's sort of a weird, at least for me, it was sort of a weird transition. I sort of just like finished my last test and I got the complete. I emailed my mentor and then I just sat around. It was sort of like a weird, unceremonious day, but it was nice. I mean, a few weeks later, I got my degree in the mail and a few other emails from the program mentor. You'll get your degree. You will still have access to your WGU account so you can do your finances. And you'll get access to this earlier on in the course. But once you're finished with WGU, is really when you're going to start ramping up your job search. And one way WGU helps you is by providing access to a job board called Handshake, which really helps connect students with organizations. And so you'll be using that a lot, and you'll be using your WGU email to gain access to that, and you'll start looking for jobs. So that's pretty much what happens when you're done. I've seen that some people can go to the campus. I think it's in Utah or somewhere. I'm not really sure if they do it state by state or how they do it, but you can go if you want to like wear the cap and gown. I chose not to because I don't really care about those kinds of things. I think this is one of the main things that I want to stress about going to school is that when you first are considering why you're going to school or why you're trying to get your degree, it's generally, in my experience, when I talk to folks, it's because they think that getting the degree will get them a job after once they're complete or once they're finished. But the reality is getting a degree is nothing more than strengthening your case for getting hired. It doesn't necessarily translate to a job or even a job in the field that you're studying in. So I just be aware that when you're coming to the end of your course, that you may not find a job right away. You will still probably need to go out and job hunt. And even if you have that credentials saying that you studied the your area of expertise doesn't necessarily mean that you have the experience that employers are looking for, but it does give you a better chance than had you not gotten the degree in the first place. So just sort of level your expectations that after school, it doesn't directly mean you're going to get a job. It just means that your resume is strengthened by your experience going to school. So it's been a really long time since I've logged into my WGU, but basically this is what it greets you with. This is new. Last time I came onto this site, it wasn't as polished. But this is my home screen, and you can see I have a bunch of emails and notifications that I need to go through. But yeah, it just says that I'm all set, that I got my bachelor's of science. It has a couple of here for alumni resources like attend a commencement, career development, learning resources, refer a friend, give back, join the Night Owl network, something that you can do to join with other folks to get your, you know, just connect with other people that you went to school with here at WGU. Let's see, action items. I have no action items. Let's see. Yeah, and then you have your financial services. So let's see what would happen if we go to this career development. It just offers like, yeah, this is the Handshake that I was mentioning. So like, let's log into Handshake. You can use WGU's form to log in. And then this is Handshake. This is like you're logged in through Western Governors University. Handshake has access to some information like what degree I went to and like when I graduated. So it offers employment opportunities that match well with what I went to school for. So that's one something that's pretty cool about Handshake. And then the other thing is occasionally I'll get like outreaches from certain recruiters asking if I want to like join their program or join, like get a job, but recruiters reaching out to me trying to like get my attention. But yeah, I haven't logged in here in such a long time that obviously like some people are trying to get a hold of me and I just haven't gotten back. But you know, they're like recruiters that are saying if I want to work, you know, at their corporations and at their jobs. So definitely something to keep in mind that when you finish, you'll have this access here, something that's really valuable that WGU provides. There are other kind of job boards. So like, let's say you're in the information technology job board. It provides like a handy list of places where you can build your resume and get certain jobs with different boards here. So like, if you wanted to join the intelligence community, you can do that. You can go to DICE. Same thing with business. They have different, like, so I'm in marketing, what's over here? So yeah, I would suggest that I join different marketing boards like with the Career Network or the American Marketing Association to help me get jobs like that. Same thing with teachers and same thing with health professionals. So you'll definitely get some access to different alumni resources that'll help you along your way. I wonder what else there is to explore. The alumni, what is this? Stay on top of your game. You can still learn stuff, I suppose, through different. You can stay on top of your learning through these different associations and institutions. That's the Alumni Network, the Night Owl Network. What does this do? Start to connect and give back, discover. Oh, sweet. And it has like different jobs that people are looking for. This is in California, more jobs. Cool. So in the Night Owl Network, you'll sign up and then you can look through some jobs here. And I think you can even get mentoring. You can join groups and events. And there are other resources to take a look at your resume. So another really cool resource here that you I guess these are things in my network. But yeah, that's another cool thing that I'm going to look into later. All right, well, hopefully that cleared up some questions you may have had when you finished WGU. There's a lot of resources that the university provides for alumni. It can be as ceremonious or unceremonious as you want. Definitely when you finish your last course, it's going to feel a little weird. You're just like going to send off an email and be like, I don't know what to do from here. But WGU tells you, like, you'll need to do this and you'll need to submit an application and we'll verify that you finished all your courses in the way that in the way that WGU supports and accepts. And then you'll be done. And then you can move on and start looking for jobs. And hopefully you'll find something really, really quickly. If you have any other questions, let me know in the comments and I'll let you know what my experience has been. As I said in the beginning of the video, I've sort of moved on to a more technical aspect, but there was a time right after I graduated that I joined a logistics company doing sales, not marketing, but it was sales, which is related to revenue creation. So yeah, I'll stop there and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.